right, gonna be heading into match for semifinals. P1 versus Cloud9. Who will move on to that finals match in Vancouver?
He was just checking, making sure there's no vision or anybody coming up while he's clearing the board.
Playing it very smart. Takes a different check.
Waiting. He thinks he's safe.
And here comes Contracts with the ulti. Hits himself. Flash is up. That's Ryu's flash.
Pinch on the bottom lane. Block able to get out pretty easily so far.
Look at that damage!
Chain back, okay. He doesn't have a chance.
Not so easy! Doing an admirable job of evading them right now. They still have the Stand United as well. Someone does get picked!
There's one hit. Inori over the wall to put himself in between, but it's not enough. Jensen's able to clear the damage necessary. Zig would have a pretty big part to play here. He's got to hit the right people, but then he puts himself in the Baron Pit. He only goes for Sneaky to stop some of the AD damage. Ryu tries to get in, bounced out, put in by the team, and he takes Baron damage, going down to Jensen. Now they're onto Inori, and that's the arrow you were saying, Kobe. They still had to continue the fight.
And now they set Jensen up. Here comes a little bit later.
Teleport, keep the minion alive. Look at all that damage on the turret. It's going to go down.
Now onto Zig. Zig with the Guardian Angel is going to come up, but like I said, that slow prevents
one
to get everything they want. There's more slow, there's more lockup, and there's the deletion of Arrow as C9 is inside the base. What a patient game from both teams as it opens up around
Jensen,
30 minutes.
More.
Baron's all
the
cloud not needed. Get it in from the turret. And the last two back is going to keep him alive. That's the shield necessary coming in from Smoothie in the bot lane. And they're going to be going for the Nexus turrets. 34 minutes in, Cloud9 break the base, and Cloud9 follow into the Nexus to take game. Moon is ready. We're about to get onto the Rift.
Who's subbing in? When? Why? Right here, Arrow.
Same play.
Flash.
Deja vu for the bot lane. Contracts comes in for the same kill for himself. You guys said once the jungler does something, the other one has to respond, and Inori did just that.
Ryu?
Shockwave onto Ryu. Almost gets taken down as he's pulling in Inori for the fight. If they weren't able to get enough damage, that's going to be the ult. From downtown, Contracts.
They're trading a whole bunch in Contracts. Yeah, this is like a moth to a flame here. A jungler to a gank.
Oh, why not? If there's trades, you got to bring a partner. Three's the crowd now for Zig in the top side. Scarl's out. And I think this is the first time Zig will be two. And it looks like they're going to feel confident towards the bot lane. Chain of Corruption goes down. Contracts is going to beat Inori first. Yes. Teleport comes in. And Arrow's gonna be the one locked down. Ray just has everyone in the party zone. Inori's gonna get next, and Zig could be the triple. Gets this over the wall. Command Shockwave's not gonna do too much.
When he revives, though.
Oh, Jensen. Zonya the Shockwave.
Oh, instantly deleted, though. Gets the damage off onto Arrow. There weren't enough on the ground.
He wants
the damage he wanted. Remount doesn't happen. Contract picks up the kill. One for one in both
damage coming in
from the team. Contracts now trying to do so.
Ryu.
He gets the kill. Double kill onto Ryu now. Now they're looking for Arrow. Ray's coming in. The flag and drag close. The ultimate's down and almost up if they can continue the long fight. A triple
Quadra.
Kill for Contracts. Looking for the Quadra. A Quadra kill. And Sneaky takes the last one to clean it up. A full ace coming in.
Contracts is an absolute beast.
Ready in T-5, and we are on the Rift. Game 3 here of the semifinals. BO5 and Cloud9 look.
I'm wondering when those things came out. I was like, this plant looks busted. Hold on. Hits Ryu.
They're going to find him. That could be first blood. Parallel Convergence would have had him locked down. Remember the flash room
matchups? He's still almost around that 10th per minute mark.
Oh, gets locked up.
He's feeling here. Corner breaks back. Hell is up, and now they might have Meteos. That flash is down.
Yep.
Didn't have enough forward.
Currently, though, a lot of attention top lane.
Impact hidden in the bush. He does this all the time. Zig flashed out.
A little bit of separation in this terrain to try and stop Contracts. But he's got the movement speed. The long range caught.
Jensen on the flank, and they're getting pinched in. Arrow available from Sneaky. Hit stun.
Ooh, he tried to back up. The team will look to help him. Jensen's going to go into 2v1 situation. Stun's exploded by Contracts on the rest of the team. Now they're on the Meteos in the back line. P1 can't even get the staggered fight on different members. It's Cloud9 coming up with the fight for themselves with re-kill. And bot turret, but in no way, shape, or forms are there waves or members ready to make that play. Chain of Corruption does slow it down, but Impact's already out, and Impact is already locking more down. There's the kill to start off the fight. Contract slow, he goes down to the Cataclysm, and now the fight continues. Depth charge back to Ryu. Zig, one shot from going down, and Sneaky sneaks one in to pick that up for himself. Snow Stunt follows through. And now Ryu's gonna have to hide, find safety under the turret or solace on the fountain, because nothing outside the base is
Oh, you got the hook!
There it is from Impact, another long-range hook. The follow-up kill to come through, and Jensen picks up another one, 2-3-0 as they continue in. We're only looking at 40-second death timers here. So Cloud9 also has to be careful going into the base. But they throw that to the wayside. Careful is not in the book.
Cloud9 determined to get their spot in the finals. And Phoenix One will get their chance in the third place match. Still such an upward trajectory for that team.